Welcome to the next class. And today we are going to deal with Mrigashira Nakshatra. We will look at the mantra of Mrigashira, the stories related to Mrigashira, the remedies related to Mrigashira, and the result of people born in different padas of Mrigashira. And once again, before I start with this particular thing, let me tell you something. The knowledge that I am going to give you can be used for ascendant, can be used for planets, can be used for anything. Even if you have your Bhrigu Bindu in Mrigashira, you can use this knowledge. Even if you have your Gulik and Mandi in Mrigashira, you can use this knowledge, right? Understand that Nakshatra and Rashi is a portion of the sky. And all the attributes that we are talking about is on the portion of that sky only. Getting my point? So the attribute of Mrigashira is given to any planet or any point who is in that particular nakshatra or that particular Rashi. Mrigashira, like every nakshatra, have four padas. Two padas will come in Taurus, the first and the second pada. And two padas will come in Gemini, the third pada and the fourth pada. Because the nakshatra is segregated into two parts, right? Two padas in Taurus and two padas in Gemini, it is known as Dwi Pushkar Nakshatra. And Dwi Pushkar and Tri Pushkar is auspicious. It is good. So normally, any planet in Mrigashira is considered to be good. It is auspicious. It is benevolent. It is benefic. This point is clear up to this extent, right? There's no confusion. There should be no confusion about this particular. If you have gone through my Bhrigu course, in my Bhrigu course, I have taught something. That is, the span of nakshatra is not always equal. We think that every nakshatra is 13 degree 20 minutes. But that's not true. The span of nakshatra is different. And sages like Aryabhatta, etc. have told it specifically that for the matter of predictions, every nakshatra cannot be taken as 13 degree and 20 minutes. Some nakshatras are bigger and some nakshatras are smaller. If I get good feedback on the videos, if I get good feedback on the comments, then I will try making one separate video on the span of nakshatra. You know, the span of nakshatra being different is the prime reason behind anyone saying that, sir, I am born in Mrigashira nakshatra, but my traits don't match with Mrigashira nakshatra. Because the span of the Mrigashira nakshatra is different for predictive purpose. However, for now, just use the knowledge based on what you know. 13 degree, 20 minute, every nakshatra, right? Once again, if I get good feedback, I will be sharing that secret technique with you as well. There is one more question that I have to address before we go with Rohini. So there was a comment by someone in one of the YouTube video that, sir, Adolf Hitler is having Mercury and Ashwini, so he is a very influential speaker. I am also having Mercury and Ashwini. I am not that influential speaker. Why? So you have to understand one particular thing. There is something known as Raj Yoga in astrology. If there are good combinations, if there are good yogas, then the result is very good. Then the result is good to an good extreme. Getting my point? So the analysis of Raj Yoga and the general analysis of the horoscope should be done. But there is one more point. What is the ascendant of Adolf Hitler? Libra. I think, no, if I am correct, it is Libra. That's why the seventh house. In the seventh house, there is Mercury. For Libra ascendant, ninth lord and 12th lord will be Mercury. And because it is the ninth lord connected in the seventh house with the Lagna lord, that is making a Raj Yoga. And he is making Raj Yoga while being in the Ashwini Nakshatra. For that reason, he was very influential in his speaking. So generally, suppose like Mrigashira indicates extension. Okay. Mrigashira indicates extension. Now this extension or expansion, whatever you say. If the 10th Lord is there, the business will be big, the business will be vast. If Saturn, the significator of profession, is there, then also the profession will be big, the profession will be vast. If both the 10th Lord and Saturn both are in Mrigashira, or say it is an Aries ascendant where the 10th Lord and Saturn is the same planet, then the business will be extensive, and that extensive will be more extensive as compared to the previous extensive. Getting my point? And in the same scenario, take like, you know, it is a Aries ascendant horoscope where Saturn, the 10th Lord, is in Mrigashira, conjoined with Jupiter, the 9th Lord, then it will make a Raj Yoga. Then the business will be even more extensive. Getting my point? So only having Saturn or only having 10th Lord in Mrigashira, the field of work, the profession is extensive. Having both the Karaka and the planet both in Mrigashira, the field is very extensive. If there is a Rajyoga, if that planet who is in Mrigashira is also making a Rajyoga, then it is even more extensive. So there is a gradation, and you have to understand that gradation. Okay? Going further. So as I told you, the first thing is that Mrigashira is extensive. There is a word, Vivatani. He is all pervasive. Mrigashira is very extensive. The planet which is in Mrigashira covers a big section of life. And I have to explain you this particular thing, okay? When I say that it is extensive, what does it mean? Sometime, suppose you are having Mars aspecting Mars in your seventh house. So your spouse can fight, your spouse may be doing physical violence with you, etc. Multiple things, okay? Or your spouse can be aggressive. In a normal nakshatra, only the marital life is guns and roses. Right? Other part of life is not that bad. But when the Mars in the seventh house, or the seventh Lord, or the Karaka Venus goes in Mrigashira, then the result is even like, you know, that is very extensive as to affect other areas of life also. For an example, suppose that it is in a Scorpio ascendant, okay? Is Scorpio ascendant 7th house Taurus? And in that Taurus, there is Mars. So Mars in the 7th house, it will be a fighting relationship. There will be fights in relationship. And if this Mars goes to Mrigashira, then story will be that my husband beat me so much that I was unable to go to office. So the result became extensive, right? Because of that fight, other things in your life is getting hampered or affected in one way or the other way. This is what I mean when I say it will be extensive, it will be expanded. You think about it? Generally, what happens inside the bedroom should not be disturbing the other part of life, right? But it does when it is in this scenario. That is the thing with Mrigashira. You know why? Mrigashira is the golden deer that came in front of Sita. There was a Maya. It was an illusion, but it took the whole attention of Sita. And Rama ran behind it, right? So that is Mrigashira. Anything in Mrigashira, it can be very small also. It can be very small also, but it will come as this big that it will overshadow all your senses. The Maya illusion is very prominent with Mrigashira. The illusion is very prominent with Mrigashira. The senses stop working in front of. So Mars in Mrigashira, when this person is angry, anger will overtake his normal qualities also. When Jupiter is in Mrigashira, then this person loves reading. And because of that reading habit, or say person loves worshipping, and because of that worshipping habit, he will ignore his family member. I know of one person who was so much into worship. He had two children and he was so much into worship that he was posted in a particular place. And whenever he had holiday, he used to spend his whole day in sadhana, whole day in puja, etc., whole day in worship, etc. And he never visited his family member. He only visited his family member twice or thrice in a year. Getting my point? So the result is so extensive that it starts covering other part of life also. Point one. And secondly, the problem with Mrigashira is there is an illusion. So if Venus is in Mrigashira, while the person wants to achieve something, see, the planet in Mrigashira will come to disturb you multiple times. Will keep on coming and disturbing you. The planet in Mrigashira. So when there is Venus in Mrigashira, whenever you want to do anything, a lady is supposed to come and disturb. A lady is supposed to come and make you senseless. Getting my point? Venus in Mrigashira, you wanted to start something, then a lady, that can be your wife, that can be your mother, that can be your friend, advised you something. And then you started thinking on that advice and you stopped working. So it hindered your work, it disturbed your work. Or rather say, you followed the advice of the lady and you haven't got that successful result that you were expecting. The result was compromised. Because you gave over importance to the advice of the lady, right? This over and loss of senses. These two things are indicated by Mrigashira. So despite Mrigashira being a very good nakshatra, it have the power to overshadow. When the 10th lord is there, the person will be so influential in his profession that he will overshadow the complete market. That's a very good result, right? But when the bad planet is there, suppose 6th lord is in Mrigashira, then the person will be so much diseased that he will not be able to do anything else. Right? It will overpower. That is the prime thing of Mrigashira. And the advice, the remedy that I will want to give you is don't run behind the things of Mrigashira, because that is a golden year. Generally, Mrigashira comes with illusion. Right? The things of Mrigashira are illusionary. Got my point? The things of Mrigashira are illusionary, and my special advice will be to not to go or not to run behind the things of Mrigashira. Getting a point? Try to avoid running behind those particular things. So that is just a golden deer. Right? And you know, Mrigashira is very strongly attached to the sense of that I have done a bad karma. I will tell you one thing. You know, Mrigashira indicates, you know, there is a saying in Hindi. Na khate ban raha hai, na ugalte ban raha hai. There is a saying in Hindi that neither you can gulp it down, nor you can throw it out. It is generally told for, you know, when you have taken big things. When you have made a promise that you cannot complete, neither run. That situation is indicated through Mrigashira. And the sense of the karma is very strong. Mrigashira generally comes with commitment. Mrigashira will lead you in a situation where you can neither complete the promise and can neither deny the responsibility. That comes with Mrigashira. So when the seventh lord or Venus, etc. is in Mrigashira, in that scenario, what happens? Suppose you got married. Okay. Of course, you will get married. So suppose you got married. And after marriage, say, you know, like the husband had family, of course, everyone's supposed to have. So the husband had family. And so there was, say, two sisters of husband and parents. And suddenly after marriage, everyone dies. The mother died, the father died. Sister was married, she got divorced. Now this responsibility came up to you. Your husband or you, whatever you say, getting my point. So getting in such situation where you take a particular thing, you know, generally Mrigashira people, if they are in job, then generally they are in a situation for which they are not qualified enough. So they are, Mrigashira person, he can be on a very high position, but he may not know how to write a mail. Problem. Getting my point. You have got the job by the favor of luck, because Mrigashira is lucky. But to gulp that down, to control it. Mrigashira indicates, you know, someone who is not deserving to be famous became famous. Now he cannot handle it. You must have seen it with many people. Nowadays also, no? People will get fame and they will not be able to handle it then. They will start abusing or doing something, right? So Mrigashira is blessed, and as it will bless you with multiple things, but you know that blessing needs to be taken care of, you know. That is the first thing with Mrigashira. Along with this, Mrigashira is known as Anvaka. Right? Mrigashira is known as Anvaka. It is very much related to a type of lust, a type of desire, a type of intoxication, right? Mrigashira is very much related to intoxication. You know, the kasturi that is in the navel of the deer, right? Mrigashira is a deer. So that, you know, Mrigashira is all about getting struck. First of all, the deer is having multiple horns. And you know, the horns are a problem for the deer. He can neither kill any, he cannot attack with that horn. He can only sue the animal. He cannot kill any animal using that horn. And generally what will happen, because deer is a vegetarian animal, right? He will not eat non-vegetarian food. He's a vegetarian animal. And generally when the deer will go into a bush, his horns will get stuck in something, and that will create problem for the deer. Generally it creates the problem. So the Mrigashira planet, you know, it should not go in a group of people. It should not go in a bush. So when the seventh lord is in Mrigashira, make sure that your spouse is not having a friend circle, not having a vast friend circle. So that is supposed to create a problem. When the tenth lord is in Mrigashira, then make sure that you work alone. You don't have a team. Right? Mrigashira, there is two big things with Mrigashira. Don't overburden yourself, first of all, one thing at a time. Should be present. Two things at a time will get stuck. One thing at a time for Mrigashira, lesson one. And secondly, you know, don't bother for the crowd. Don't bother for the people. If you pay heed to what the crowd is saying, if you pay attention to what someone is saying, then it will be a problem for you. And specifically, the Mrigashira have to be very careful about what they want. If Venus is in Mrigashira or the seventh lord is in Mrigashira and you are saying that I love this lady, think again. You may not be loving the lady. It can be just lust or infatuation, which you are mistaking for love. And after marriage, you will come to find out now he became fat and I don't love him anymore. What to do? Because deer is supposed to. Getting what deer is supposed to get into such scenarios, right? So you know what the hunter will do? They will make a, they will dig somewhere in the ground and put some grass over it. The deer will go to eat the grass and will fall. So senses, control over senses. We talked about this before also. Right. And you know what? There is one very specific thing with Mrigashira. He want to make the other person inferior. This quality of that, I will make you feel inferior, is one of the biggest problems with Mrigashira as well. In Mrigashira, never try to prove yourself superior, or never try to prove anyone inferior. The sense of proving yourself superior or the sense of proving someone inferior can be a problem. So when there is the third lord in Mrigashira, don't compete with your sibling. When there is fourth lord in Mrigashira, don't try to compete with your family member. And generally a competition comes. Generally a competition will come, right? Don't try to do that. Like generally people are like, you know, like if the fourth lord is in Mrigashira, generally people are like, my mother made such good food, you don't make such good food. Don't try to compare. The comparison will be a problem. That will be the prime reason for, you know what, the nakshatra knowledge is so prominent that you can avoid the small pitfalls. Like, let me tell you one thing, okay? Check the nakshatra of the seventh lord. You should never do that particular mistake. For an example, my seventh lord is Shravan. Right, suppose. If I don't listen to my seventh lord is not in Shravan, by the way, don't assume. But suppose my seventh lord is in Shravan. In that case, if I don't listen to my wife, it will be a problem. My seventh lord is in Hasta. If I don't support my wife in household duties, it will be a reason of break. And you know, the nakshatra works very subtly. You don't know from where the problem is coming. It is the inner tendencies of the mind. People are not able to understand it. Maybe your wife will fight with you saying that you are disloyal. But the real problem will be that she will be thinking, if I am making food in the kitchen, why he is not in the kitchen? What he is doing in the bedroom? He is messaging someone else. So the doubt also comes from you not helping her. So seventh lord in Hasta, Venus in Hasta, when she is in kitchen, go join her in the kitchen. Right? This is...
सर, इफ आई कुड शेयर
प्लीज,
मिक्सिरा का जो आपने बोला है, देयर आर लॉट ऑफ प्लेसेस वी हैव सेड अबाउट दिस केस एंड दिस हैपेंड अ लॉट. यहां पर एक लेडी थी जिनकी शादी होने वाली थी विद अ पर्टिकुलर पर्सन. फैमिली ने ढूंढा था, बट इनवेरिएबली आफ्टर फ्यू मंथ्स द इन लॉ स्टार्टेड टू आस्क फॉर डाउरी एंड हर पेरेंट्स टोल्ड हर लेट्स कीप दिस मैरिज, लेट्स लुक फॉर समवन एल्स. बट वो छूटा नहीं. And this lady happened to go and alag se private mein shaadi kar li usse. And then they got married and finally went and settled down abroad. So again, one illusion. I always say, I don't know why, but Nikshira jab bhi aata, I tell them, don't fall for love marriage. It's the biggest problem that it will give. Wahan jaane ke baad, after a few years, after two children were born, her spouse actually left her and came back to India while she is still in the UK. And it is a very bad scenario. Even now when you ask, the person will come and ask you, okay, you know, I want to get this done. What should I do? And the next meeting when they come, they'll ask you something totally different. So, ये जो illusion का है, ये जो senses का है, और ये जो एक तरह का शक का है, plays out very well in Mrigashira. This case is something which I keep telling. Mrigashira is one of those nakshatra which really confuses you as to which part to take.
Generally, what happens in a love marriage, you know, people are like, generally what happens with them, they are like, you know, you are very beautiful, I want to get married to you. The woman will be also like, you are young, I want to get married to you, you are the man, you are young and everything. But after marriage, you will become fat, filled with obesity. You will not be any brave. When you meet him for 1 hour in 1 month, right, he will be fighting with the other guy who is looking at you in the restaurant, that why you are looking at my girlfriend. But no one will tell you why you're looking at my wife. No one does that. Right? You keep on living with the person day by day. So, you know, this big thing goes with, you know, this big thing goes with Mirgashira. Always. I have always seen this. They will confuse affection with attraction. They will confuse caring with, you know, like he is very much disturbing in our home. They will misunderstand things. That is there.
So one of the things that I tell such people is, okay, you know, stop, or rather I tell the spouse, you know, funny lagega, but then don't let your spouse conquer you completely. Thoda unse dur ro. So there'll be some sort of chase and romance which will keep happening and you'll stay happy. This has worked a lot, sir.
Yes.
Once aap ekdam meek ho jao aur wo spouse jo bhi bole maanne lago, sab karo aur spouse ko lage theek hai, then it's sort of ke wo aapse bore ho jate hain and it falls apart. But when you tell them, you know, पूरा उनके हाथ में नहीं जाओ. I've seen it working brilliantly, sir.
Seduction is the key. Of course, deer keeps on jumping and running. That comes to one more point. Now, deer is jumping. So they are like, you know, they will finish one particular thing and they will want to jump over things. They are tend to take shortcuts and that shortcut is multiple times problematic. Right, so shortcut, whichever planet is in Mirgashira, try not taking shortcut in the particular area of that planet. That will be problematic. So if there is ninth lord in Mirgashira, don't do remedies. Because you want to do shortcut to get your luck. So remedy. For Vikiji, I will put you one particular point. The mantra for Mirgashira is Somasya Anvaka Vitani Prastha Dayanto Avastha. Dayanto means weaving. So weaving is the remedy. Mirgashira people should weave something from their own hand. Generally, sweaters, etc. you can weave, right? Should weave something from their own hands and donate it to people. Generally, they should have an image of a god in their home and they should be weaving clothes for that god all by themselves. That is a remedy that I always will recommend for it. Weaving, you know, like gifting weaved clothes to people. This was Mirgashira. Right. So coming to this particular thing, Mirgashira indicates weaving. So it does indicate there, they can be working with fashion, etc. They can be working with fashion. They can be cloth merchants, like profession related to weaving, profession, organization, managing a team, guiding a team is something that they are good in. Once again, weaving, right? So taking the good quality of people and mixing them with weak people so that they both can grow together and become an asset to the company, right? That is something that Mirgashira people know very well. How to weave with people, how to make relationships, how to survive in a relationship, right? How to make connections, how to become socially influential. That is what Mirgashira people know. Mirgashira people will have best relationship with them in their neighborhood. So they know, you know, how to make that particular thing. But when Mirgashira is afflicted, they are the most aloof person, right? So depending on the planet, if it is a benefic planet, it is good. If it is a malefic planet, that is bad.
Agreed, sir. Bad team player, sir. Team leader bana lo. Team player banaye, team mein rakhe, toh they will spoil everything out.
Make them a leader, then only it will be there. And Mirgashira, the mantra of Mirgashira itself uses the word Soma, which means moon. So it have a very strong tendency like moon, as we have already discussed. They are emotionally focused, like, and they are also lured into things. Along with this, they have a very delicate sense of duty. They have a very delicate sense of romance. Their romance is very delicate, very, very heartly. Right? They are not someone who is much into the physical sphere, but someone who is much into the mental and the emotional sphere. Along with this, you know, their life is full of fluctuations. Sometimes it is good, sometimes it is bad. And, you know, for Mirgashira person, nothing in life starts without the bad news. Everything in life will start with the bad news. That happens with moon always, right? The life is full of fluctuations. The marital life is almost good. Despite Vikiji saying that he advises Mirgashira people not to fall into love marriage, but it is very difficult for Mirgashira people to avoid love. Love keeps on jumping in their life because once again, moon.
सर बहुत शकी हो जाते हैं, दैट इज व्हाट आई हैव सीन विद देम. इतने शकी हो जाते हैं कि इट बिकम्स अ डिफिकल्टी. इफ दैट इज मैनेज्ड देन इट्स अ टोटली डिफरेंट थिंग. दैट्स व्हाई आई टोल्ड द स्पर्स लेट देयर बी अ लव एंड चेस काइंड ऑफ टीम गोइंग ऑन इन लाइफ, इट विल बी फाइन.
यस यस दैट इज अ गुड थिंग दैट यू हैव डन. Going further, Mrigashira Soma, you know, the mantra of Mrigashira have the word Soma. Soma means a plant which keeps on growing all by itself. It grows all by itself. They have a very strong tendency of molding the environment as per their needs, molding the environments as per their own way. Right, so they are not the people who will wait for the change to happen, neither they are the people who can make a change. They are generally people who will work in a very subtle way and will try to get their way. For an example, say if the seventh lord is in Mrigashira, in that scenario, when marriage is about to happen, it is not like that you go on to see a spouse or a spouse comes to you. No, it is generally that you will find out that I had one particular friend who likes me, and then the relationship will start. Are you understanding my point? The thing will not start with the blast. The thing will not start with the boom. It will slowly, slowly creep in into your life. That is what happens with Mrigashira. And you know what? Mrigashira is emotional. Mrigashira is resourceful. Mrigashira is very much filled with divinity. They are generally religious people, God-fearing people. And along with being religious and God-fearing, they have a very broad chest, right? And they generally, whenever they have something, they will want to share it. So the, you know, the tendency of sharing is very prominent with Mrigashira, right? But when Mrigashira is afflicted, in that scenario, the sharing will be distorted. And in that case, the sharing will convert into people forcibly taking your share. So when Mrigashira is good, it is open-hearted sharing. And when Mrigashira is bad, it is that people are snatching away the things that belong to you. Right? Milk is very good for them. It is very essential that they consume milk almost every day. The best time to drink milk is after you wake up, before any meal, right? Milk taken with breakfast is very essential for them. And they should also, Mrigashira people should for sure drink milk before they sleep. After they wake up and before they sleep, Mrigashira people must drink milk. Milk is the greatest remedy for them. Generally, when Mrigashira is afflicted, person can have a problem with milk. So generally, there are people nowadays, which are children nowadays, which are lactose intolerant. And they have to live on soy milk. They cannot digest cow milk. So that's the case. Generally, woman with a Mrigashira ascendant or woman having prominent plants in Mrigashira may have problem with breastfeeding their children, because it indicates the udder. I will give you one strong remedy. For any problem related to Mrigashira, mix honey with milk and drink it. If there is a good planet in Mrigashira, if there is a bad planet in Mrigashira, then mix honey with milk and give it to the Shivalinga, give it to the god, give it to the deity. Right. Okay, one more thing. These people, the Mrigashira people, although they come as a very good loving people outwardly, but inwardly they are very sore and filled with negative tendencies. Despite they come as a very cheerful and very friendly people, inside in themselves they don't have very good thoughts for other people. Right? They generally have problem in obtaining children. So either there can be delayed children, no children, or abortions, etc. Right? And along with this, you know, they have a very great sense of sharing things with people, as I have already told you. So they have a great sense of emotion and emotional connect with other people. Right. So to other people, to the people in society, to the people in office, to the people in neighborhood, they connect very easily. But to the people in their own life, they are not very much connected to. With their family members, they are not very much connected to. And their emotions towards their family members is not very good. Right.
सर ये मृगशिरा परफ्यूम से भी बहुत रिलेटेड बोलते हैं.
यस बिकॉज ऑफ द कस्तूरी इन द नेवल ऑफ.
सो शिव जी को इत्र चढ़ा सकते फिर सर एज अ रेमेडी.
सर शिव जी इज अ मेल.
हाँ ओके माय मिस्टेक सर.
इत्र इज जनरली फॉर फेमिनाइन डिटीज. ओके they generally have problem related to puking. They generally have problem related to vomiting. Because Mrigashira also means vomiting. Mrigashira also means, you know, like puking out. Mrigashira person generally have good life, long life, and Mrigashira is good for longevity and health. So if the 6th Lord, 8th Lord or 12th Lord in Mrigashira, that is actually good. And it does indicate that there can be other problems, but the person is surely saved from diseases. Disease and ill health will not disturb the person very much. Even if the person is diseased, in that scenario also the disease will be in a very dominant, very dominant condition. Very compressed condition, and it will not disturb the daily life and the daily duties of a Mrigashira person. Generally very good for longevity and very good for gaining power. Mrigashira person will surely gain power, right? And that power will come very subtly and very slowly, but surely one day they will gain power, right? So if they have how do you interpret it? If the 7th Lord is in Mrigashira, then maybe your spouse is not very beautiful as compared to the spouse of your brother. But over the time, you will find that the spouse of your brother had a bad, but you will find that your brother had a bad marital life and you have a good marital life. So what happens in the end? Your choice is proved correct, right? So that generally happened with Mrigashira people. At start, that choice may not look good. Their choice in starting may look as a foolish decision, but over the time it will prove to be correct. So suppose you join a particular job and you tell your Mrigashira friend to also join that particular job, like some your friend who is having Saturn in Mrigashira or your friend who is having 10th Lord in Mrigashira, you also tell them to join the job because that is good paying job. But you know, the Mrigashira friend denied. He said that I will not join, you only join. In that scenario, what will happen? The company will soon shut down. And you will realize the importance of that. Whatever my Mrigashira friend was saying, that was better. I must have also remained in that company because he is now working in that company, and the company that I joined is now shut up, and I have nothing to do. Getting my point? Worship of moon, worship of Hanuman, worship of Lakshmi, and worship of Shiva is very crucial, or can serve as a remedy. These people are very powerful and they are well equipped to do things. They are well equipped to, you know, they are well equipped to do things in life. They are well equipped to, you know, carry out any work. They are generally very hardworking people. Okay. So I think we have covered a few remedies, and we have also covered the significations, right? Now I will, for this particular thing, I will be giving you an example, okay? I have told you multiple things related to Mrigashira. Now suppose you are having ascendant or moon in Mrigashira, then all these qualities are going to come to you. Suppose you have your 2nd Lord in Mrigashira only. In that scenario, second house indicates family. And what I told for family, that these people will have jealousy towards their family member. But At the same time, good relationship with neighborhood, right? Neighborhood or the instant family will seen through the third house. So if the third lord is in Mrigashira, then they will not have a very good emotions toward their siblings, but they will have very good relationship in with the people in their neighborhood, because you know third house indicates neighborhood, right? So in this particular way, you have to, you know, read the result. For an example, if I'm talking about money, if the second lord or the 11th lord is in Mrigashira in that scenario, because it indicates expansion, right? Mrigashira indicated expansion. So for that matter, if the second lord or the 11th lord is in Mrigashira, or if Jupiter is in Mrigashira, or Moon is in Mrigashira, that is very good for money and finances. If the 5th lord is in Mrigashira and you want to know about child, you know that it is not very good for child. Right? If the 6th lord is in Mrigashira and you want to know about health, then you know that Mrigashira is very good for health. Right. Regarding marriage, as I told you, right, that they will generally be lured into love. Love will keep on coming in their life. Generally, it is indicated that their love relationship will be their very will be very close friends only, right? And they should be careful in their relationships, and they should not try running behind things which are false. So, for an example, suppose if the 8th lord is in Mrigashira, then how do you tackle with this, you know, running behind false things? If the 8th lord is in Mrigashira, then don't run behind. If you take this policy today, sir, after 10 years, you will get this much return. Don't run behind it. You are going to get no result. You will be the most unfortunate person, right? So don't run behind things, right? If the 10th lord is in Mrigashira, then there are a whole lot of predictions that I have told you, right? So it is to be used in this particular way, right? Any planet in Mrigashira, ascendant or moon in Mrigashira, you should be able to make predictions, right? And I am pretty sure that it is not difficult to make. If you think that it is difficult to make, go through the video once again and take notes of the thing that I have told you. And try giving those significations to the planet in Mrigashira. Right? So if the 10th lord is in Mrigashira, take all the significations that I have told you and try reading it with respect to the 10th house, and then you will understand how it is going to work. Right? Now let me come to the result of different padas in Mrigashira, result of different quarters in Mrigashira. Right, this have been with Mrigashira. I will tell you a few more things before we go to the padas. Right, which house is connected to Mrigashira? Which Rashi is connected to Mrigashira? Mrigashira is connected to Capricorn. So if there is a malefic planet in Mrigashira, Capricorn is going to get afflicted. If Capricorn is afflicted, then the planet in Mrigashira is also going to get a problem, right? Right. Okay. Coming to the padas of Mrigashira, the first pada of Mrigashira comes in the Taurus Rashi and Leo Navamsha. So first pada of Mrigashira is extremely terrible for marriage. Also bad for health, but is good for longevity. But generally, the first pada of Mrigashira indicates challenging health in the starting part of life. Okay, I will tell you result for all the 12 houses. A challenging condition in the starting phase of life, the longevity will be good, but up to young age, the person will be diseased. For the Mrigashira first pada, very bad for mental life, and never make a woman your enemy, because you are supposed to be defeated by woman. So never ever take panga with woman, never ever fight with woman, right? It is good for finances, and generally such people will get some money from their spouse as well. Regarding siblings, they are supposed to have one male and one female sibling, right? Not very good for quarter for having a good relationship with family member. The relationship with family member, specifically the relationship to parents, can be a bit problematic. Generally, Mrigashira first pada indicates that the person will love maternal uncle or maternal aunt or paternal uncle or paternal aunt more than their own parents. Generally, they will be more attracted towards the relative of their parents rather than being connected with parents themselves. right? Regarding children, the first pada of Mrigashira is not very good, right? The first pada of Mrigashira gives you disease, but doesn't give you enemies. It will give you quick win over enemies, right? The person born in the first pada of Mrigashira, his eyes will be like a lion, right? So more round in shape. His teeth will be very white and charming, right? He will not be easily defeated, as I just told you, right? His nose will be big and prominent. He will sometime work with full dedication and sometime will leave the work, sometime will ignore the work. So for 15 days, he will be highly workaholic, and for 15 days, he will be highly spending, resting in complete leisure work, right? His hair will not be good. His hair will be hard and, you know, difficult to handle, right? Generally indicates, hard hairs generally indicate a tough financial time in the starting part of the life, at least before 40s. There will be a tough financial time, okay? The first pada of Mrigashira, worship Shiva with the Namami Shimishan Nirvana Rupam Shloka. Okay, if you can find the shloka, all the very best. If you can't find the shloka, don't ask me. There is specific remedy per pada also. Coming to the second pada of Mrigashira, the second pada of Mrigashira will be Taurus sign and Virgo Navamsha. Once again, bad for marriage. The person specifically is dirty and will have problem related to dirt. So dirty in thoughts, dirty in appearance, and anything can be there, right? But problem related to dirt is for sure. There is generally problem related to dirt, problems such as infection, etc. Problem because of being bitten by some animal, etc. is also indicated. Mrigashira second pada, don't have a pet animal, please. Okay, having a pet animal is not recommended for you people, right? It is very good for the person becoming influential, very good for people in business. It makes you a businessman, very good for finances. The person is very good in speaking, right? He will be able to influence people like anything. It gives professional prominence. It is very good for people to be in social media business or speaking business or in business related to oratory, right? Family relations are generally very good, right? Their relationships with the relatives are bad, but their relationship with their family members are very good for the second pada of Mrigashira, right? Generally, they have only female siblings, like only sisters. Right, their relationship with their mother and father both will be good, but they will love their mother more as compared to the father. They have very strong connection with their mausi, the sister of mother. They have a very strong connection with mother's sister, right? And for child, it is a bit problematic for progeny. The progeny can be a bit delayed. If the progeny is on time, then the progeny is a nuisance. Then the progeny is a problem. Progeny will be trouble creator, right? In the matters of health, it will give you good health, but it will give you very strong enemies and very strong opposition. Mrigashira, second pada, no work of yours will be completed without obstruction. Obstruction will be then and there at every step, landmines everywhere. Generally indicates a successful love marriage, right? It is not very happy. The marriage is not happy. If you learn to compromise in marital life, it is very good. If you don't learn to compromise in marital life, this can become a great, great problem. The best key to make the relationship survive is to treat your spouse as a friend rather than treating as a spouse. As I told you, helping in the kitchen, treat as a friend. The eighth lord, Mrigashira second pada will indicate that the person is endowed with good longevity, and generally they will have problem between 28 years to 32 years of life. between the 28 to 32nd years, they will have multiple problems in their life. Generally, religious people very much into worshipping and visiting temples, right? For profession, I told that business is good, right? And for remedy, worship Lakshmi Narayan, both Lakshmi Narayan together. And how do you worship Lakshmi Narayan together? Which stotra you think worships Lakshmi and Narayan together? To worship Lakshmi Narayan together, read Puru Suktam first, followed by Sri Suktam. That is how you can worship Lakshmi Narayan together. Or have an image where Lakshmi and Narayan both are sitting together and worship that particular image for the second pada of Mrigashira. Okay. Second pada of Mrigashira, people are generally respected. As I told you, it is very good for working in social media. It is very good for working in business. The person will have strong respect. Many people will respect him. His physical composition will not be that great. His body will be weak. He will not be able to carry much weight, etc. Right? He will be a bit coward. He will not be someone who will go and fight for even for his own rights. If someone wants to exploit them, they can be easily exploited. They will have a lot of anger, but generally that anger will not come out. That anger will remain inside them, making them frustrated. Right? Along with that, they will have a beautiful body. Many people will be attracted towards them. Their tendency is not very good. They are generally endowed with the tendency of cheating the people who help them. Right? So that is not good. They will be fortunate in terms of money. They will be famous. Specifically, the area below navel will be weak as compared to the upper area. So upper body can be heavy, but the legs area can be a bit weak. Generally, problems related to veins, problem related to knees, problem related to legs are there. Flat foot, you understand? Flat foot. Generally, these people are having flat foot and knock knees. Flat foot and knock knees are two conditions, which is evident there. Mrigashira, third pada, comes in Jaimini sign. Jaimini. Mithun. Very good for relationship. True love in life. Very good marital life. You love your spouse. Your spouse loves you. You both support each other wholeheartedly. Right? They are very good in working. They work very hard. They are dedicated towards everything in life. Generally, they are underachievers. They don't get the recognition that they deserve. Along with this, they are generally having some very strong disease. Generally, coming by the end part of life, they will have very strong disease or they will be suffering from some hereditary disease. Right? And it is good for finances. It gives good relationship with family member. With some family members, there will be good relationship. With some family members, there will be bad relationship. Generally, there will be good relationship with the family member of mother society and bad relationship with the family member of father society. Generally, relationship with the younger siblings of mother and younger siblings of father is very good. It is good for finances, good for making money, good for investment, but very bad for saving money. Generally, if they have siblings, they will only have sisters, so they will not have brothers at all. Regarding the home, it is very difficult for them to make a home or live into a home. So even if they purchase a property, they will not be able to live in that property. And when they start living in that property, there will be multiple problems in the property and multiple problems in their life. So it is highly recommended you don't make a property, you live in a rented home only. Because once you start making a property, multiple problems will start coming, and most importantly, there will be multiple problems related to people dying. So many people will start dying in your family here and there. Not only close ones, even relative distant people can also start dying. Right? It is good for like the children is a bit delayed, or they themselves decide not to have children for a particular point of time. When they have children, they will generally have daughters only. It is good for having good health. And it also gives, you know, like very few enemies. It is not a nakshatra which will give you very strong enemies, the third pada of Mrigashira. Right? So it will give you no disease at all. Even if disease is there, that disease will not be very prominent. That will be a very small type of disease, like infection, etc. only. And enemies will also not be there. But this person is biggest problem for himself only. He himself, his ideas, his desires, you know, he running behind the lust, etc., is the biggest problem. Right? That is the biggest problem that he have to come across. Generally indicates a love marriage and a happy marital life, provided the fact that the husband and wife behave like friends rather than behaving like couples. Okay. And Annapurna needs to be worshipped. Annapurna. There is a specific mantra for Annapurna. There is a specific stotra for Annapurna, and the temple of Annapurna is in Varanasi. They will have prominent hair all over their body. They will have beautiful eyes, but also will have problems related to eyesight as well. Right. Their nose will be beautiful, and some deformity in the nose will be there. Or either they will suffer from cold and cough very often. Right. They are generally not very fair in complexion. They are generally a bit on darkish side in complexion only. And even if they are fat, there will be no fat on their hands and legs. There will be only fat in the chest region, belly region only. But generally, the hands and the legs are not that fat. And generally, you know, they have a problem related to their posture. So they either don't sit straight or they either don't walk straight. And so that is something that needs to be taken care of, because it is very much prominent, very much prone to have a bone related disease. Okay. Coming to Mrigashira, fourth pada. All the bad things that I have told you for Mrigashira is for the easily applicable to the fourth pada. Okay. Because once again, it is a moksha pada. So being a moksha pada, the Pushkar part of the Dvi Pushkar part of Mrigashira is going at this particular point. Right? Another, it is the fifth nakshatra from the Ashwini. So fifth is once again difficult. Right? So the fifth nakshatra. See, every even nakshatra, first nakshatra, third nakshatra, fifth nakshatra is difficult to deal with. It's difficult to tame. The significations of that nakshatra is difficult to overcome. And this is a fifth nakshatra, a male nakshatra. The significations are difficult to overcome. And once again, it is a moksha pada of the nakshatra, right? The Mrigashira fourth pada. So generally, all the good results of Mrigashira comes early in life. And by the end of the life, only bad results remain there. They generally have problem related to speech, problem related to speaking, problem related to bones, problem related to energy. Right, so it is generally the fourth pada of Mrigashira is generally indicative of someone who was very agile in his young age, and by the time they will start reaching their old age, they will be more stick to the bed. They will not remain that much active. So it indicates a person who will be very active in his young age and will be totally immobile in his old age. So that particular tendency needs to be taken care of. For marriage, it is not good. Generally indicates late marriage. Right? There are strong arguments between husband and wife. In a female chart, she can also beat her husband also. And the husband will be docile enough to get beaten. Right? Very bad for emotions. generally Mrigashira fourth pada person will have very strong emotions and there will be no one with whom they can share the emotion. They will have to keep the emotions with themselves only, right? And when they are in depression, when they are in distress, no one is going to help them, right? They will easily gain properties, lands, convenience, etc., right? But saving money, giving it to family, or using their money for themselves is a problem. That giving your money to other, very good. Purchasing a property where your whole family lives is very good. But if you want to spend money on yourself, that can be a problem. The siblings, if there is one sibling, then that will be only female. If there are more than one sibling, then they will be a mixture of male and female, both brothers and sisters. Relationship with mother is not very good. Relationship with father is very good. Right? Children they will have, but a few abortions are indicated or a few loss of children is indicated. Generally, they will be a victim of wrong treatment or they will be a victim of wrong medication early in the childhood, which will create multiple complexities for them further in life. Right? They will have no enemies at all. They won't have very strong health problems also. Like health problems will be there, but the health problems will be very much dominant. Very much subservient. So that will not be disturbing them. To be very honest, there can be diseases lying in their body. And at the same point of time, they can be a very, very good in their work. But the biggest problem with them is their unsettled mind, their fickle mind, and their ability to overthink and making things complex. Right? About marital life, I already told you, if it is a late marriage, it is good. If it is an early marriage, there will be a disaster. In a marital life, don't expect your spouse to do something. Take complete responsibility yourself. If you expect your spouse to do something, then it will be a problem. A spouse is generally very docile and will not be able to meet the expectations that you had from your spouse. So in the case of love marriage, this becomes a great problem. For longevity, it is good. For longevity, it is good, but both in the starting part of life and in the end part of life, the person is diseased, heavily diseased. Okay. Remedy is Hanuman in sari. Okay. You will find it very rare places. Either married Hanuman or Hanuman having vermilion all over his body, sindur, or Hanuman in sari is the remedy. If you can find it, please also let me know. Right?
Sir, Hanuman in sari, kya boli sir? Sorry.
Chola chadate Hanuman ji ko yaar. Chola, the female dress, na sari, chola. Should I tell you the place? Off recording, why tell it to YouTube people? Let me tell you. There is a place before Kanpur, Panki Dham. There's a place before Kanpur named Panki. The Hanuman temple in Panki is a very good remedy for Mrigashira fourth pada. Specifically, you know, Hanuman lying on the ground. That is also a very strong remedy for Mrigashira fourth pada. And so because I have covered very subtle remedies in between, I have given special remedies in the end. Okay. So let me tell you a few more things about Mrigashira in general. Of two, three more things. And as I told you, Mrigashira is indicated by moon. Everyone loves moon, right? Everyone loves this Mrigashira person. Whichever planet is in Mrigashira, you know, people think that you are blessed in that particular area. If seventh lord is in Mrigashira, people think that you have the best spouse. If the fourth lord is in Mrigashira, people think that you have the best mother. But the reality is just opposite, right? So Mrigashira is more like a showpiece. Whichever thing is in Mrigashira, people will think that you are blessed in that particular area. That will not be the case. That is one of the biggest thing. Right? Generally, 80% of the time, this Mrigashira person is used as a showcase only. Showcase. right? The planet in Mrigashira is more like a showpiece. You know, like Venus in Mrigashira. You are very beautiful. Everyone loves you, but your husband doesn't like your face. You have straight hair, he like curly hair. You are white, he like black. Because Mrigashira indicates the eye in the feather of peacock. That is literally of no use. That is only for show. Right? More to ugly hota hai na, peacock is ugly. Right? So that is what comes with Mrigashira. Along with that, this person is highly respected. In whichever field they are respected. And they are endowed with a special power that even if they don't know the subject, many people of that particular subject will come and take an advice from them. So if Jupiter is in Mrigashira, despite they not knowing anything about religion, many religious teachers will come to them and will ask for their advice. And you know, there is one very particular thing with Mrigashira. For 15 days, they will look beautiful. For 15 days, they will look ugly. For 15 days, they will be gaining weight. For 15 days, they will be losing weight. Generally, anyone having connection of moon with the ascendant or the seventh house or Mrigashira, this is generally the case. 15 days looks very beautiful. 15 days looks terrible. This is generally what happens, right? I have many more significations, but I will not teach that particular for Mrigashira because I want everyone commenting that, sir, please do long classes. After that, I will think. Okay. That's enough for Mrigashira. Thank you for watching it. Namaskar.
Thank you, sir.